Yes, this is the moment you've waited for. You've been searching in the dark, your sweat soaking through the floor. And buried in your bones, there's an ache that you can't ignore. Taking your breath, stealing your mind, and all that was real is left behind. Don't fight it, it's coming for you, running at you. It's only this moment, don't care what can gather. Your fever dream, can't you see, getting closer. Just surrender, cause you feel the feeling taking over. It's fire, it's freedom, it's flooding open. It's a preacher in the pulpit and your blind devotion. There's something breaking at the brick of every wall. It's holding all that you know. So tell me, do you want?
It's time to audition for our next season of Competition Team. We have some exciting updates about it, and I'm going to show you our quick registration form that you can fill out. It is completely free if you fill out today and sign up for an audition slot. A couple of the changes that we're going to be doing to Competition Team this next year, we are so excited about it. My goal was to make it more focused and create even more opportunities for this next year. And wow, what an amazing feeling to be able to actually plan this next year. So this is our audition registration form that you can jump on and register for right now. It's a quick Google form. I give a quick explanation of what is expected at each audition. The times, they're going to be Thursday, August 5th, 6th, and 7th. A quick explainer of what our different teams are. And you fill out your name, parent guardian name, parent guardian email, the performer's name and email, and also which audition times you are looking to get. And that's it. And you'll submit.
This was the most epic birthday party, most epic birthday party, the most epic birthday party ever.
Entire story of Skylar's epic birthday party, the dramatic twists and turns, and the final revelation that kids have the power to take care of themselves, even if it isn't always easy. Embrace the relationships you have with those close to you, and always be nice to those who show up at your birthday party.
Everybody, I am so excited to announce a brand new feature to our studio that is open and available to all registered students, and that is our Born to Perform community app. This is where students can log in, create their very own profile, access any of our online challenges, online classes, and schedule their private lessons directly from our website.
I got my crown. Don't need a hero to lift me off the ground. I built this heart. It's beating loud. Won't let no bad blood ever bring us down. Keep flying higher. Fight like a fighter. Want it from everything that I will ever need. A queen messiah. A strong survivor. Even the worst days will get the best of.
don't stop, stop the music. We ride fast like a bullet.
I hope you guys were able to watch a little bit of that slideshow. That slideshow is going to be playing at intermission as well. The road to this year-end show 2021 has been an adventure. It's been quite crazy. As you saw, we went from having a beautiful studio space to being in a playground, to being in a park, to being in a parking lot, to now our own studio space where we're able to record, rehearse, and have our own outdoor stage. It's been incredible, and it couldn't have happened without the support of you guys. So give yourselves, thank you guys so much. You guys are all incredible. We have an amazing show planned for you guys. It's gonna be about an hour, 45 minutes, and we have a 15-minute intermission. Our program is online. There is a QR code that you can scan that was up in the front. But in the very beginning, we have a bunch of incredible soloists that are going to be performing for you from our competition team this year, our teen competitors. And after that, we will go into intermission. And when we come back, we have some group final presentations for you guys. So that's all I'm going to say. We had some technical difficulties with our live stream today. I plugged in my computer and broke the church's system on accident. I am so sorry, but we are recording this live. It is being recorded right now, and we will be uploading that to YouTube and sending everybody who did the live stream a recording of this, as well as all of you guys. You guys will all get a recording of this. With that said, I do want to say thank you so much to Bob for helping from Cal Church. Yes. This church is amazing. The venue is amazing. It's super incredible. This church is my home, and I'm so grateful that I'm able to have my year-end show here. So hopefully many, many more shows in the future. So without further ado, I would like to welcome up our first... Oh, no. Oh, it's a recording. Our first soloist, Maddie Ragsdale, who is not here with us today. Well, actually, that is the wonderful thing about this last year is many of our things had to be pre-recorded and live-streamed, so we got creative with how we delivered our shows and made it accessible. So this year, we have many of our performers, many of our classes were actually virtual, and many of our performers were not able to be here. So we pre-recorded them, and they will actually be performing with our performers who are live on stage as well. But we do have, we're starting off with acting skills. Enjoy.
Is it time for the show yet? I don't know. With all this virtual stuff we've been doing, I am not sure how we start a show. Been way too long. But is it time to start?
Everybody got your mics on?
Check.
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 Check your mic. Button in the left-hand corner.
Better?
Yes, much better.
Everyone's camera lens clean? No one wants to look blotchy.
Blotchy or not, this face could launch 1,000 ships.
Yeah, because they're trying to sail away from you.
What did you say?
Folks, let's not fight this close to the show.
So it is time for the show?
Only if there's an audience. If there's an audience, I think we can start.
Wait, but our cameras have been on for like 5 minutes.
So?
So that means people have been watching?
Wait, already?
Can they see us right now?
I think so.
Ah! Hi!
What? because there might be people out there.
But aren't we putting on the show for people?
Yes, but we don't want them to see us before we're ready.
Yeah, it'll ruin the show.
What good is hiding gonna do?
Yeah, we need to know if there's an audience so we can get ready.
Okay, that is a good point. What do we do?
Someone needs to check who's gonna do it.
Not me!
Not me.
Definitely not me.
I'll do it.
There are people out there!
Really? Let me see.
Wow, there really are.
They look really small.
Hey everyone, come see how small they look.
Wow.
Whoa.
Oh my goodness.
Oh, so they are supposed to stare at us.
I think so.
Oh!
Fine then, keep staring. But it doesn't mean we have to like it.
Well, I think this is an audience. Places everyone, places! 10 seconds everybody.
Where are my tap shoes?
10.
Lucky, let go of my costume.
9.
I broke my wine prop. Mom, where's the super glue?
8.
Me. Last time I ate a whole bag of Skittles before trying to sing. Me.
7.
Top of the day. Tip, top, tippity, toppity, snip, snop.
6. No, Mom, I don't want any lasagna right now. I'm about to put on a show. 5.
Wait, what's my first line again?
4.
Just say to be and then make up the rest. They'll never know.
3.
Butterflies. I think I'm having butterflies. Do I have time to Google what butterflies feel like?
Oh boy. 2.
Aw, man. My cat just had a hairball on the keyboard.
1.
Well, welcome.
And the event of awesomeness on stage.
Applause.
Cheer.
Because this is a place where heroes are born.
Where memories are made.
We invoke the knowledge of the past.
The happenings of the present. And the wishes of the future.
Hoppers become princes.
Kings become common folk.
And stars are born in an instant.
And like comets, disappear before your very eyes.
You blink and you will miss it.
In a snap, something incredible happens.
You watching us.
Us entertaining you.
And for a brief moment, magic.
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 The universe opens up.
The planets align.
You are part of a great happening at the center of a spiritual awakening.
Because tonight is the first night anyone will ever see this.
And no one will ever get to see it this way ever again.
Welcome.
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 Welcome and on
with the show.
My name is Maddie Ragsdale, and I'm singing Someone Like You from Jekyll and Hyde the Musical. I picked this song because I've always been known to be a belter, and I wanted to stretch myself, and this song has some mixing, it has some head voice, and it also has some belting, and it is a hard song. It is a challenge, and I love challenging myself, so that's why I chose this song. Definitely my most memorable event was winning first place at MTCA. As a group, we all worked so hard, and it was so nice to have that work be shown and be won. And I was so proud of everyone, and we were all jumping up and down when we got that first place, and it was one of the best days ever. The biggest challenge that I overcame this year was definitely dancing, because I was really confident in my singing and my acting, but not so in my dancing levels. So this year I worked so hard at going to every dance class and practicing at home and pushing myself and doing all of the above to be confident and great in my dancing abilities. And I think I did really well this year, and I'm really proud of myself. I want to give a shout out to one of my best friends, Anna Cardina, because she's always been there for me from the beginning, whenever I was stressed out, whenever I was really sad, or even my best moments. We were always there for each other, and I honestly would not be here without her. Thank you all so much for coming. I'm so happy that you're all here to watch all of my talented fellow actors. Please enjoy my song and the rest of the day.
Life go by, dream of tomorrow.
name is Amy Julian, and I'm singing To Make You Feel My Love. I've always loved this song. It's been one of my favorites since I was really little. I remember my dad used to play it when I was going to sleep, and I love singing it and playing it. Honestly, I think it was keeping my voice, like, healthy and, like, able to be used, because I was, during the pandemic, it was like I didn't want to do anything. Like, I didn't want to go anywhere. And singing was, like, towards the beginning, it was, like, not something that I would, like, I would just kind of go on my phone. I was, like, you know. But I think that towards the middle, I started learning more. I started playing more on my piano. And so I was, like, okay, well, maybe I should give singing a try. So I started to practice more and more. And I think that that was probably, in the beginning, the most challenge. My most memorable thing that happened this year was definitely the Halloween cabaret. I had so much fun. That was the most fun I've ever had, ever, probably. That's an exaggeration, but it was very fun, and I really enjoyed singing that song. I think that switching from the lower notes to the higher notes, especially when it goes to da 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 da, that part is kind of a difficult switch to go from down in my chest voice to like up in my hand voice so quickly. Some tips that I would give to younger performers who want to be, you know, a performer is to not be shy and to really just put yourself out there. Like, especially here, the people aren't here to judge you, they're here to help you and help you improve. And I think that for me, throughout like middle school, I lost all of my confidence in myself. So it was harder for me to like put myself out there and like actually like try belting, because I'd never tried it before, and all of that kind of a thing. So I think that I would just be confident in who you are and don't like be embarrassed, because you are amazing. I hope you enjoy my song, and thank you for coming to Yes. I'm Emmy. Hi. I'm just gonna start. Okay. When the rain is blowing, thank you.
Disneyland from the musical Smile. I picked this song because I adore, absolutely adore Disneyland, and I know how magical it can be. And in this song, she wants to escape from all of her problems, and I totally feel that because with COVID, I've just been stuck in my house, and I could just only dream of going to Disneyland and just not having to think about any of it anymore. In this song, it was really hard to have every single beat have a separate emotion, because she's feeling so much emotion that it's just so overwhelming, and I wanted to really bring that into my performance. And I think I overcame it, but hope it comes through to you guys tonight and you guys can see it when I perform it. I loved the competition weekend. It just brought everyone so much closer together, and just winning at the end was just the cherry on top. It was awesome. I would just say to just completely be yourself and throw yourself out there, because even if you don't sound the best or you don't like look the best dancing, as long as you are feeling comfortable and you're just throwing yourself into it, making yourself look ridiculous, it's gonna look great. First, I want to thank my mom and dad for finding this song for me, because it is perfect and I love it so much. And thanks to my dad again for helping me with my acting through it, because I wouldn't have been able to perform it the way I do now without him. Thank you so much for coming tonight, and I hope you enjoy my performance.
Hot Sunday night, I guess the folks were busy fighting. Joe'd already left home, 11 years old on my own, feeling nothing but lonely. There's nothing to do, there's nothing out there but the traffic down on State 93. So I'd sit through the night by our old black and white TV. And that's when I saw it, that's when I heard it.
To Disney. Rain on My Parade from Funny Girl. I chose this song because I love this song and I love Barbra Streisand, and it's really a challenging song, and I'm so excited to be singing it for the year-end show. The biggest challenge I faced was probably just like everything, COVID and not being able to see people and not being able to talk to people. That was really, really hard. My favorite memory from this year has to be winning first place at MPCA, because we all worked really hard and we all really bonded, and it was so amazing to win first places. It was so much fun, and the whole weekend was so much fun with all the classes and the workshops and stuff. My words of wisdom to a new performer would just be, don't get discouraged, don't give up, because there's a lot of people out there, there's a lot of competition, and most of the time you won't get the part. And a lot of the time it's not even because of your talent, it's because of the way you look or your height, or you know, just based on who you know. And so just keep trying, because if it's what you love, then do it. I'd like to thank Brent so much, because he's worked so hard, and Ryan and Lexi and Natalie have all worked so hard on our MTCA performance and on this performance, and just all the different holiday performances throughout the year, and also just all the competition team, because they're all so nice, and I am so, so glad that I got to know them, because I feel like we really bonded, we got really close, and they're like one of my favorite people to hang out with. Yeah. So, thank you, and enjoy my performance.
Don't tell me not to live just in putter. Life's candy and the sun's a ball of butter. Don't bring around a cloud of rain on my parade. Don't tell me not to fly. I've simply got to. If someone takes a spill, it's me and not you. Who told you you're allowed to rain on my parade? I'll march my band down. I'll beat my drum. And if my band's out, your turn at bat, sir. At least I didn't fake it. I guess I didn't make it, but whether I'm the rose of sheer perfection, a freckle on the nose of life's complexion, a cinder or the shiny apple of its eye, I've gotta fly once, I've gotta try once, only can die once, right, sir? All life is juicy, juicy, and you'll see I'm going to have my fight, sir. Get ready for me, love, cause I'm a comer. I've simply gotta march, my heart's a drummer. Don't bring around a cloud of rain on my parade. I'm gonna live and live now. Get what I want, I know how. One roll for the whole shebang. One throw, that bell will go clang. Mr. Unseen, here I am. I'll march my band out. I'll beat my drum. And if I band out, your turn at bat, sir. At least I didn't fake it, hat, sir. I guess I didn't make it. Get ready for me, love, cause I'm a comer. I've simply gotta march, my heart's a drummer. No, nobody is gonna rain on my
sing songs that are more dramatic or even more mature. And so I really wanted to challenge myself a little bit. I always just go for huge, big songs. And this one is big, but there's a lot more underneath it, and I want to explore that as an actor. This year, I really learned how to build a song, like how to start small and end big instead of just going big the entire time. And I'm really proud of myself for learning how to tone it down and then get bigger. Definitely my fondest memory is winning first place in FTCA for our competition medley. That was the best feeling ever. We're all crying already. There's so much anticipation, and then we see our name first place Sondheim, and it was like screaming and crying and just so much hard work went into it, and just feeling that release was the best, literally the best thing ever. I think my biggest advice would be just to do everything. Like, I think I'm someone who just like, once I realized, I think it was like in seventh grade, that I like really wanted to do this, I signed up for everything and I auditioned for everything and I was at every dance class, every voice lesson. If you were able to do these things, then just do everything, because nothing, you can only gain more. You can't lose anything from going to everything that you possibly can. I want to thank everyone here at Born to Perform Studio. I want to thank Ryan for helping me with acting, and Brent, of course, with voice, and Lexi for literally everything that she does, and Keenan for all the dancing, and Rebecca for all the dancing, everyone here, and my parents for letting me do all of it. And thank you all for coming and watching, and I really hope you enjoy my performance. I don't want to talk about things we've gone through, though it's hurting me. Now it's history. I've played all my cards, and that's what you've done too. Nothing more to say, no more ace to play. The winner takes it all, the loser standing small beside the victory. That's her destiny. I was in your arms, thinking I belonged there. I figured it made sense, building me. The gods may throw a dice, their minds as cold as ice, till someone way down here loses someone dear. The winner takes it all, the loser standing small. It's simple. Judges will decide, the likes of me abide. Spectators of the show, always staying low. The game is on again, a lover or a friend, a big thing or a small.
Grayson Manley, and I'm going to be singing Breathe from In the Heights. Well, I really love theater, and I missed it a lot this past year. And I'm so excited that everything's opening up now, especially the new In the Heights movies coming out. And I just really wanted to sing Breathe from the musical because it pushes me to use my mix and my head voice, so it's a great challenge for me. And I'm so grateful that the studio and everything going on now, we're able to get back together. So my biggest challenges within the song would definitely be on the vocal side of things. You know, I mentioned earlier that I picked the song because it pushed my mix and my head voice. And throughout the song, there's several spots in it where I have to switch into head voice or go into my mix. So there's like spots where I need to relax, take a deep breath, prepare, but don't strain my voice to go into mix or even head voice at the end of the song. So it's definitely been a challenge starting it, transitioning into getting it to a place where I feel confident in my mix and my head voice, and also sounding great while acting it. My favorite memory from this year has probably been MTCA because it was just a great experience. I did it in 2020 as well, and I loved it then. And this year, although it was online, everything, I still learned so much in the workshops, and doing my solo was also very fun. I sang Stupid With Love for Mean Girls for that one, and that was a different genre of music normally than I do because it was a little bit more funny. So it was just a great experience, a lot of learning opportunities throughout the course, so that's why it was my favorite memory this year. My advice for a newcomer would just be mix things up a little bit, you know, don't get your heart set on like one genre of music. Try different styles and genres because you'll be amazed at what you can accomplish. And that's for me is speaking like vocally, because lately I've been trying to mix things up a little bit, but that could even be for dance and acting. Try different things and you'll find what you really love to do. I would just like to say thank you so much to my family for driving me to my vocal lessons, helping me get involved in different productions throughout the community for the past year. I know it's been a tough year, but it was definitely so much fun, especially being able to keep doing theater throughout it. So thank you so much. Thank you guys so much for coming and supporting us. I hope you enjoyed the performance. This is my street. I smile at the faces I've known all my life. They regard me with pride, and everyone's sweet. They say you're going places, so how can I say that while I was away, I had so much to hide? Hey guys, it's me. Biggest disappointment, you know. The kid couldn't hack it. She's back, and she's walking real slow. Welcome home. Just breathe. Just breathe. As the radio plays, hold forgotten the letters. I think of the days when the city was mine. I remember the praise. I te adoro, te quiero. The neighborhood waved and said, Nina, be brave and you're gonna be fine. And maybe it's me. Seems like a lifetime.
spine. Smile for the neighbors, everything's fine, everything's cool. Standard reply, lots of tests, lots of papers. Smile, wave goodbye, and pray to the sky. Oh God, what will my parents say? Can I go in there and say, I know.
Thank you, guys.
Hi, I'm Ava Maloney, and I'm going to be singing Lost in the Brass from Band Geeks. Well, I kind of wanted to step out of my comfort zone and do more of a bit of a comedic song, because I've been doing a bunch of ballads, and I kind of wanted to switch it up, so. The thing that comes to mind is most recently is when I was actually getting my adjudication done during MCCA, where there was a FOSSE class going on right when I was singing my song, and I was super nervous because they had been taking a break and they were all watching me and they all had their eyes on me. It was on the like the big last note, so I was like, oh my gosh, I'm so scared. And then it was I like did it and it was like the best time I ever did, and they were all applauding. It was like a really cool moment. I think dealing with like the anxiousness and anxiety of performing again after such a long time is kind of like a weird thing to get back into, but I think that it's a nice healthy change from where we were, so. Using my mix, because I'm still trying to develop it, and definitely in this song there's some like really hard moments and challenging moments for me. There's a time in the song where I say shine and then I like keep going up and like it just keeps escalating and getting harder. I definitely think that's probably one of my favorite points in the song because of how challenging it is and how fun it is overall, so. Accepting and being thankful for the anxiety, because I know personally before performances I always get super nervous, but the anxiety always goes into front of performance and makes it just better as like the nerves just go away. But realizing that is a big part of performing and like taking in the anxiety and appreciating how it can really benefit your performance. I hope you enjoy my performance. Thank you for coming.
There it goes again, the moment's gone, and I'm too lame to speak. Another wasted opportunity. Always waiting for something to happen, but nothing's gonna happen. Not for me. Buddy, I'm a girl for your information, forever in this situation, waiting and hoping he'll notice how I'm feeling. But every time I get him near, I fade away, I disappear. That's me, never getting heard. He just smiles and walks away like I never said a word. Oh, can anybody hear me? Am I just blowing now while the whole world marches past? I blow and blow, though I know it gets me nowhere. I just get lost, lost in the brass. Flutes don't sparkle quite like batons. There's no visual attraction, no stimulus reaction. Pretty music, that's all the pretty that I got. I'm special in a quiet way, at least that's what my parents say. Whatever, they were never in the band. Their hair is turning gray, no they don't understand. Oh, can anybody hear me? I just know
makeup. I don't stick my hair up with some awesome-tastic pink barrette. No, I'll never be a majorette. I'm plain, I'm basic, and I sweat when I get nervous. I suck at popularity. People just don't notice me. Someday, high school's got to end, and I'll finally find a place where this woodwind doesn't blend. Oh, there's a whole world to be pursuing. If I could just get out and leave this all here in the past, yeah, they'll remember me thinking, gosh, how is she doing? But I'll be long gone. Oh, I'll be solo obligato, cutting loud and clear, right through the tube of glass, soaring high above that clumsy bass vibrato. I won't be lost in the brass. And finally they'll see there's so much more to me.
And I'll be singing If the World Should End from Spider-Man Turn Off the Dark. I chose this song for a lot of reasons. When I originally called with Ryan to pick a song for MTCA, we went through a ton of options, and he asked me if I wanted to sing a song from the Spider-Man musical. And I automatically thought yes, because I'm a huge Marvel fan. And the song was perfectly in my range, so I figured, why not pick a song that I actually really, really love to sing for MTCA? So I chose that one. One of the biggest challenges for me in this song was that I usually play and sing like comedic roles and really faster paced things. So a lot of those things are super easy to act because all you have to do is just be energetic. But for this one, it was kind of harder for me to become like subdued and raise the stakes for myself. That was really hard for me because I'm not used to singing ballads and things with a very serious tone to them. So that was one of the big challenges. The second one was being able to be subtle in my acting. That was hard for me. Having to, you know, look at my facial expressions and see like, okay, that micro expression, it makes me look kind of happy when this is sad. So I had to kind of work through that, but it ended up working, I think, so. My fondest memory this year with the studio was the Halloween medley that we did earlier in October, where we got to perform that at the Halloween drive-in. That was so fun for me, because I love Halloween, and I loved all the songs that we chose. I loved the part I got to sing. And I loved being able to kind of bond with everybody. That was the first show I got to do with everyone on the team. So I loved being able to kind of bond with everybody that way while still getting to perform live for the first time in a while. One of the big things I felt like I overcame this year was really being able to step into who I am. I feel like in a lot of past years, I've kind of like hid my real true self away from people. And this year, I feel like I really learned how to actually step into who I am and be confident in the person that I am and who I'm meant to be. You can be yourself, and that is what's gonna make you succeed. Just being yourself and knowing who you are and knowing what kind of person you wanna be, that's what's gonna help you. Not trying to be somebody else, not trying to hide behind a fake personality. Just be yourself, be who you're meant to be, and that will carry you everywhere. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope you enjoyed the song. Thank you very much.
Don't think about tomorrow, we've only got today. There's nothing that I want from you, not a word you have to say. You are all I need and all I can defend, all I need to hold on to. if the world should end. In my imagination, I could not have made this up. In a world stranger than fiction, ours is no fictional love. I can see the you under your second skin. I can feel your heartbeat quicken, and then slow. There's nothing else I need to know, and there's nothing you need to pretend. If the world should end and the sky tonight is luminous for all tomorrow, I'll have today again. There's no time for sorrow when there's no such thing as time. And if the darkness will descend, I don't need a savior or a friend. I can say I've really loved if the world should end.
Thank you.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back. What a great first act, right? Incredible performances. We have a lot more for you guys. All of our group presentations. From all of our group classes. I just finished a pretzel from Rebecca. Rebecca, those pretzels are amazing. Thank you. Guys, sit back, enjoy the show. We have our acting skills classes. We have act and sing, triple threat, youth and teen, triple threat tap. Triple threat youth and teen tap classes, and our competition team coming up. So enjoy the rest of the show.
I am thrilled you could all make it tonight, gentlemen. I know I ask a lot of you, but I hope you all realize I noticed everything. Every tiny smile, every every sacrifice given. You're my man, aren't you? And tonight you're going to prove it. Now, I want you all to pick up your instruments and line up in... You, stand up straight, please. I said stand up!
I think lunchtime is about the worst of the day for me. Always having to sit here alone. But then, sometimes mornings aren't supposed to be either. Waking up and wondering if anyone would really miss me if I never got out of bed. Well, there's also the nights. Lying there and thinking about all those stupid things I've done during the day. And all those hours in between when I do all those stupid things. Well, lunchtime is among the worst times of day for me.
So I flew and I took a taxi to get to you, and I just had to come and see you. Thank God you're... Oh. Wait. I'm sorry. You're not... I'm so sorry. Does Daniel Harding live here? I'm looking for a Daniel Harding. He lives here, I thought, but... Oh. He doesn't, does he? I'm so sorry. I am just so embarrassed. Who is this woman, and what is she doing here? I just honestly thought he'd be here. I always thought he'd be here. Always.
I'm celebrating because I got a friend who tells me all the things that ought to be told to me. I'm glad you spoke to me like you did, but you'll see, I'm gonna change. And Emily, I wanna ask you a favor. Emily, if I go into State Agricultural College next year, will you write me a letter? The day wouldn't come when I wouldn't wanna know everything about our town. You know, Emily, whenever I meet a farmer, I ask him if he thinks it's important to go to agricultural school to be a good farmer.
What is it, like I talk too much? Is that it? Like I talk too much and you're sitting there in absolute silence thinking Leia talks too much. I wish she'd just shut up once in a while. Is that it? Because you need to judge me, okay? I just, God, fine, I'm admitting it. I talk too much, so kill me, Phil. Call the police, lock me up, rip out all of my teeth with a pair of rusty pliers. I talk too much, what a crime, what a sin. What an absolute catastrophe, stupid, evil, ridiculous, because you're not perfect actually, Phil, okay? There, I've said it, you're not. God, do I disgust you?
You ask me why I don't talk to you. Why am I what you people call a loner? Well, I'll tell you. While you and your friends lived in your neat little suburban houses, I lived in this really crummy apartment, and while you had your cute little rooms, mine was the size of a postage stamp.
Don't do it, Artie. Leave him alone, Uncle Louie. You want the bag open? Do it yourself. Maybe you don't rob banks, grocery stores, or little old women, but you're worse than that. You're a bully. You pick on a couple of kids, your own nephews.
When I was 8 years old, someone brought me to a theater with lots of other children. We had come to see a production of Peter Pan, and I just remember something seemed wrong with the whole production. Like, odd things kept happening. Like, when the children would fly, the ropes would keep breaking, and the actors would come thumping to the ground, and they'd have to be carried off by stagehands. And there seemed to be an unlimited supply of understudies to take the children's places.
The psychologist said that I wasn't cut out to be a nun. He said that I was unconsciously trying to break out of contrast with common life. It's not the obscenity. I got no bigger thrill saying fart face than yelling red light, green light, or barking like a dog. It was the impropriety of it. That's all I wanted. To shock people. To shock myself. I've been numb for months. I mean, there I was. I had everything planned out. I was committed to a life of service in the church. And suddenly it was Sister Stupid.
And let me tell you something about my father. At least he's doing something in this war. He's sick and he's tired, but he's out there selling iron to make ships and tanks and cannons. And I'm proud of him. What are you doing? Hiding in your mother's apartment and scaring little kids and acting like Humphrey Bogart. Well, you're no Humphrey Bogart. And I'll tell you something else. No, that's all.
So beautiful, I see.
friends like Katarina, Caitlin, and Peyton.
I learned how to dance better than I did before. Before I was in that bitch, I wasn't really good at dancing.
You are wonderful.
Sing in front of people more because I'm not a very good singer in person.
You've definitely gotten more comfortable in front of people and performing. Yeah, absolutely.
Pretty's on the inside, see it in your own eyes. Look a little closer in the mirror tonight.
Making a character. Set.
Action. What now? Annie, what are you doing?
Running away.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness.
Don't care. I'm getting out of here. Okay. I'm ready. Wish me luck.
Interacting with each other, and this is what we call character analysis too, right?
I really like the acting, the dancing, the drawing, and pretty much everything about it. And I especially love my friends in the acting class, and I especially love my teacher.
We are so real, we are so rare, we see
bye.
it's Natalie. So I taught youth musical theater and youth tap at the studio, and it's been so much fun. I also got to work with some Saturday dance workshops and some mini musicals, and I choreographed both competition teams. So my students are going to show you some of the stuff they've learned throughout this year.
Energy!
Joy!
Cool!
This class was so much fun. I loved it. It was a really amazing experience. And I would like to thank my mom, my teacher, and life.
This class was really good. It was a really good workout. And now I'm a very good dancer. So, progress! And I would like to thank my mom, my family, my dad. Thank you.
I would like to thank Born to Perform for these classes and Natalie for being a good dance teacher and my mom and yeah.
Step is riff-offs. My favorite thing was probably learning new tap steps.
My favorite tap step would have to be time steps. The session was really amazing because I got to spend a bunch of time in person and on Zoom with my peers and amazing teachers, all of which I love.
My favorite tap move is a paradiddle.
I really liked being in tap class because I grew a lot. When I first started, I couldn't do a Broadway, and now I can. I'm thankful that I have good friends like Mo and Jenna and people on competition team. Thankful for Natalie for teaching me and for, you know, sticking with me for a month when I didn't have tap shoes. And yeah.
Hey mom, dead mom, I need a little help here. I'm probably talking to myself.
Thank you so much to the parents for your continued love and support, and thank you to the studio, and enjoy the rest of the show.
Thank you.
Are they doing great, everybody?
Yeah!
This is the time where I fill in a little bit because we have some costume changes happening right now. But up next, we have our competition team showcase for you guys. It's been an incredible year with our competition team. As you know, as a group, they took first and second place in the national MTCA competition with their group numbers. It wasn't me, I promise. I couldn't be more proud of them. They're, resilient is the word for them this year. They followed us through rehearsals in the park, in parking lots, and in our parking lot, to our outdoor stage, to filming in church parking lots, and they've really shown a ton of strength, and I admire every single one of our competition team kiddos. They're just so talented and so amazing. This year and last year, we presented awards, individual awards on our end, not just MTCA, but awards to recognize each of their hard works and things that they were able to accomplish. And there was one particular award that we are going to make a tradition at Born to Perform Studio, and that we will be announcing at our year-end show. And that award is the coveted Triple Threat Award. Last year, Anna Cardino took our very, very first Triple Threat Award. And the Triple Threat Award goes to somebody that shows an incredible amount of effort and discipline and work ethic in all three disciplines, and she definitely does that and continues to do that. So nobody more deserving to get our very first Triple Threat Award. And this year, Maddie Ragsdale took our Triple Threat Award. We have a plaque. As you may or may not know, we are remodeling the inside of our studio, and once that is done, we are going to be mounting a plaque that every year we will get engraved with our Triple Threat Award winner each year. And this year we had our very first Junior Triple Threat Award that we awarded, and that went to Giselle. So they will all have a place on our wall forever and ever and ever. So I think that was enough filler. Are we ready? Can I get a holler in the backstage? Holla! Okay. So without further ado, after MTCA, we started preparing our other medleys. Our junior team did a mashup of the Mickey Mouse March. And Mickey Mouse Clubhouse. So we will be presenting that to you. And our teens did a Disney Prince/Princess medley. And many of them will be performing this live with a few of our performers who are not able to be with us, but they'll be up on the TV. So enjoy.
Let us hold our banners high.
7 a.m., the usual morning lineup. Start on the chores and sweep till the floor's all clean. Polish and wax, do laundry and mop and shine up. Sweep again, and by then it's like 7:15. So I'll reread the books if I have time to spare. I'll paint the walls some more. I'm sure there's room somewhere. And then I'll brush and brush and brush and brush my hair. Stuck in the same place I've always been. And I'll keep wondering and wondering and wondering and wondering. Can you feel the love tonight? The peace the evening brings. The world for once in perfect harmony with all its living things. Can you feel the love?
swift as a coursing river.
Be a man.
With all the force of a great typhoon.
Be a man.
With all the strength of a raging fire. Mysterious as the dark side of the moon.
I thought my heart had learned its lesson. It feels so good when you start out. My head is screaming, get a grip, girl. Unless you're dying to cry your heart out. Oh no.
Dreamed of a far-off place where a hero's welcome would be waiting for me, where the crowds would cheer when they see my face, and a voice keeps saying, this is where I'm meant to be. I will find my way. I can go the distance. I'll be there someday. If I can be strong, I know every mile would be worth my while. When I go the distance, I'll be right where I belong.
A whole new world, a dazzling place I never knew. But when I'm now I'm in a whole new world with you. Unbelievable sights, indescribable feeling, soaring, tumbling, freewheeling through an endless diamond sky. A whole new world, 100,000 things to see. Like a shooting star, I've come so far. I can't go back to where I used to be. Every turn a surprise, every moment red letter. I'll chase them anywhere. There's time to spare. Let me share this whole new world with you.
That makes such wonderful things could be bad. Look at this stuff. Isn't it neat? Wouldn't you think my collection's complete? Wouldn't you think I'm the girl who has everything? I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got who's its and what's its galore. You want thingamabobs? I got 20. But who cares? No big deal. I want more. I want to be where the people are. I want to see them dancing, walking around on those, what do you call them? Oh, feet. Flipping your fins, you don't get too far. Legs are required for jumping, dancing, strolling along down the, what's that word again? Street. I don't know when, I don't know how, but I feel something starting right now. Watch and you'll see. Someday I'll
voice. You just are ringing in my ear. And if I hurt you, which I don't, I'm spoken for, I fear. Everyone I've ever loved is here within these walls. I'm sorry, secret siren, but I'm blocking out your calls. I've had my adventure, I don't need something new. I'm afraid of what I'm risking if I follow you into the unknown. Staring at the edge of the water, long as I can remember, never really knowing why. I wish I could be the perfect daughter, but I come back to the water. No matter how hard I try, every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to the place I know where I cannot go, though I long to be. See the light where the sky meets the sea, it calls me, but no one knows how far it goes. If I win on the sail and the sea stays behind me, one day I'll know. If I go, there's just no telling how far I'll go.
Heart, don't fail me now. Courage, don't desert me. Don't turn back now that we're here. People always say life is full of choices. No one ever mentions fear or how the world can seem so vast. To the past. One step at a time, one hope.
As you know, Anjali is a senior this year and is going off to college and is one of our original Born to Performers, one of our first original Born to Performers, Aaliyah last year, and now Anjali this year, graduating and going off to bigger and better things. And as you can see, we've made many, many, many fond memories together. And even before a version of the studio was alive, she took lessons with me out of a little music room in Ice Pita. And it's been such an amazing pleasure to be your coach and director and mentor and just watch you grow into who you are today. So we just want to recognize you. So with that, that is the end of our show. But before we all go away, I would like to invite my entire team up onto the stage. Natalie Esposito, Ryan Lefton, Lexi, who else? Jared, Rebecca. And there are those that are not here, Keenan and Natalie Graham, who are all absolutely incredible. I could not do this without them, obviously. We have an incredible, incredibly dedicated and loving team here at Born to Perform Studio. I couldn't be more proud of what we have. So please, everybody, give them a round of applause for all the hard work. From going completely virtual to where we are today, they have been there the whole way, and I'm just so, so grateful. So, Ryan, get back over there, because you have work to do. Ryan edited all these videos, and he's always, from the beginning, whenever we do shows, we have slideshows, and it's always PowerPoint presentations are always part of our shows, and he is so creative, and he now knows that that's, every time we do a show or anything, he's going to be editing videos. So, and it's really, really come in handy this past year, so I am so appreciative of that. So guys, again, that is the end of our show. We have a ton of things happening this summer. I hope you all are joining us. We start tomorrow. We have a musical theater day camp that is completely full. We have about 20 kids in that. And then we have 5 more weeks of day camps for kids 5 to 12 at the studio. And those are filling up. You can still sign up. Bring a friend. We have our intensives. The Broadway cabarets are closed, but we have an incredible, oh, here it's right up there, teen intensives. We have our acting intensive with Ryan and some of his special guests. He always brings on amazing professionals in the industry to talk to the kids and give them some amazing and incredible insights. And that's June 28th to July 2nd. And that one is filling up pretty quickly. And then our next one is the following week. We have our dance intensive, which every day the kids are going to be introduced to a new choreographer, a new instructor. We have Natalie Esposito is going to be doing musical theater hip hop, who is our competition 3-4-5-time award winner choreographer with our competition team. And Natalie Graham is going to be doing ballet and conditioning. And Rebecca is coming back doing musical theater tap. And I'm so excited. We have Jess Kaufman coming to teach musical theater jazz. And Jess is here somewhere. She's here. Say hi, Jess. She's here. Hi. We're so thrilled to have her join the team and join us for the intensive. So sign up for that. And then the following week is our Broadway boot camp, where we put acting, singing, and dancing together. And we will hand select a musical theater song, a monologue, and you will have a choreographed combo that we will film. We will workshop first, and then we will film, and you can have it for real to submit for auditions and just to have for yourself. So, and if you are interested in competition team, I highly recommend joining that Broadway boot camp because the following week we have Songs for a New World. Is that up there, Ryan? We have our musical. We have Press Start the musical. It's an 8-bit musical that we're going to be doing for ages 6 to 12. It's based on all of your favorite nostalgia Nintendo video games in the 8-bit style. It's super fun. So it's from the same people who wrote our musical that we just finished, which was The Most Epic Birthday Party in the World, which is super cute, yes. And we had a ton of fun with that, so I hope you guys join us for that. That one's already half full, so sign up today. And then we're doing a teen intensive, which is Songs for a New World, which has incredible music, tight harmonies, very complex show, and I hope you guys all join us for that. That's at the end of July. And then the following week is when we're going to be doing our auditions for the following season of Competition Team. And we have some new things that we're adding to that. We have a brand new category that we're doing. So we're splitting the group into three focuses. We have our youth team, we have our teen team, and we have an open team. Our open team is what has been known as the performance troupe, who do the Christmas medley, Halloween medleys, perform out in the community. So that's what our open category is. And we're going to be also doing a couple new competitions. And we have a couple that we have our eye on that we'll be announcing within the next couple of weeks. We're very excited about that. But all the information to sign up for your audition slot is out in the lobby. There's a little QR code that you can just quickly open up with your phone and fill out a quick form and reserve a time. There are three times. I think that's up there. Maybe not. But you can learn more about that. And just find us. You can find any one of our instructors and ask us more about that. I hope to see you guys all through the summer and throughout the next year. We have a ton going on. And again, thank you all for being here today. Have a wonderful night. And I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye. Give these kids another round of applause. And have a good night, everybody.